Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Huawei WLAN technology course. I am the instructor, Jong, Yunan. In this chapter, we will study WLAN antenna technology. The content of WLAN antenna technology is not very extensive in our entire WLAN technology course, accounting for only about 5%. However, just because it occupies a small portion does not mean it is not important. Because the so-called antenna is a device that transmits and receives electromagnetic waves. Any wireless communication device cannot do without an antenna. It is the material foundation that moves WLAN technology from concept to reality. Therefore, it is necessary for us to master some of its content. After mastering this chapter, we can better deploy WLAN projects, especially in terms of antenna selection. After completing this chapter, we should at least be able to clearly define what an antenna is, that is, what kind of device it is, and what role it can play. We will also learn about its various forms, including its directionality, and how it can be categorized by polarization method, shape, and other aspects. We also need to be able to describe the basic working principle of antennas, including how they generate electromagnetic waves, and under what circumstances the generation of electromagnetic waves is most effective. Aspects such as antenna directionality and polarization mode, we should be able to state some important performance indicators, including gain, transmission power of the device, beam width, down tilt angle, etc. We need to clearly understand the meanings of these different performance indicators, their units, and what values indicate that the performance of the antenna is good. We need to be able to differentiate these various antenna parameters. This chapter's content can be divided into four different parts. In the first part, the overview of antennas, we will introduce the definition of antennas, their function, and their forms, among other content. This helps us to grasp the concept of antennas as a whole. The second part is about antenna-related technical points, which is the difficult part of this chapter, because it involves some physics knowledge that might be a bit hard to understand. We will divide it into two sections: the working principles of antennas and their classic parameters. The third part, antenna selection, is a focus of this chapter, and it is closely related to the next chapter on WLAN project deployment. The content of antenna selection will be divided into two parts: the main methods of antenna selection and recommendations and case studies for different scenarios. Introduction to traditional indoor distribution devices. For this section, a simple understanding will suffice. Because we now use traditional indoor distribution devices less frequently, what we use more commonly now is agile distribution. Let's first learn about the concept of antennas. In everyday life, we actually encounter examples of antennas everywhere. For example, the antennas on the TVs we had in our childhood, or the antennas on the radios used in our college English test listening exams, and the early models of iPhones. They had two white stripes on the top and bottom. Those actually encapsulated antennas. We have all directly interacted with antennas. Antennas are ubiquitous because they are a necessary component in all wireless application devices. Think about our wireless electronic devices, including mobile phones and radios. Their communication relies on radio waves. But inside these devices, what operates are actually electrical signals. To enable communication between them, a converter is necessary. This converter translates electrical signals into radio waves and vice versa. Therefore, antennas play the role of this converter. Thus, they are an indispensable component. As we mentioned earlier, radio waves are the medium for wireless communication. More specifically, they are radio frequency electromagnetic waves. These so-called radio frequency electromagnetic waves can be simply thought of as electromagnetic waves that propagate through the air. More specifically, they are radio frequency electromagnetic waves. These so-called radio frequency electromagnetic waves. We can simply think of them as electromagnetic waves that can propagate through the air. Their frequency range is from 300 kHz to 300 GHz. The commonly used 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz frequencies actually fall within this 300 MHz to 300 GHz range. They are part of the microwave frequency band of radio waves. Then, these radio frequency electromagnetic waves have a certain directionality in their propagation between wireless devices, just as shown in the three pictures below. In the leftmost picture, when two conductive wires are very close to each other, the electromagnetic waves they generate are confined between the wires and cannot radiate outward. When the two wires are spread farther apart, the electromagnetic waves they generate can radiate further. When the two wires form a straight line, their radiation becomes a 360-degree omnidirectional radiation. But it's not to say that this radiation can propagate in any direction. It is actually 360 degrees horizontally. In the vertical directions, up and down, there are actually blind spots. So now we can provide another definition for an antenna. An antenna is essentially a component in wireless devices used for transmitting and receiving electromagnetic waves. The role of an antenna is to facilitate the conversion between guided waves and free space waves. Guided waves refer to electromagnetic waves that travel along a transmission line. Free space waves are electromagnetic waves that propagate through free space. For instance, as shown in the image on the left, an outdoor AP transmits guided waves via a feed line to the antenna, which then directs them in a certain path. The antenna then converts the received guided waves into free space waves that can propagate through the air. Thus, the essence of an antenna is that of a converter. We can liken wireless communication to the propagation of sound. If we consider radio waves as sound, then an antenna is akin to a diaphragm in the domain of sound propagation. The antenna acts like a diaphragm that transmits sound across different mediums. Inside a loudspeaker, the diaphragm converts the electrical signals it receives into vibrational signals that can propagate through the air. Then, the diaphragm inside a microphone converts the vibrational signals it receives from the air into electrical signals that can propagate within a computer. Thus, the role of an antenna in the realm of wireless communication is equivalent to the role of a diaphragm in the domain of sound propagation. An antenna possesses three properties. One is directionality, as shown in the three images we discussed earlier. Another is reversibility. Reversibility means that the same antenna can be used both as a transmitting antenna and as a receiving antenna. The last one is reciprocity. Reciprocity refers to the fact that the same antenna has the same basic characteristic parameters, whether it is used as a transmitting antenna or a receiving antenna. Let's now learn more about the classification of antennas. Antennas can be classified based on different properties. For example, based on the directivity of the antenna, we can classify antennas into omnidirectional, directional, and smart antennas. An omnidirectional antenna, like this one here, covers 360 degrees horizontally. But it doesn't mean that the closer we are to the antenna, the stronger the received radiation signal, because its coverage area is actually donut-shaped. This means that we might not receive its signal at all directly underneath it, because there are blind spots in its vertical direction. Then, a directional antenna is like a flashlight. It emits its signal in a specific direction. Compared to an omnidirectional antenna, it performs better in a specific direction, because it uses a reflector to reflect radiation that would otherwise go in unwanted directions towards a specific direction, thus directing radiation more effectively toward that specific direction, thus achieving corresponding enhancement. This can be used in specific scenarios, such as when signal reception is only needed in one direction and not in other directions. Other directions are not required. Then, smart antennas. Smart antennas are a rather special type of antenna. For instance, we have a smart antenna here. It can receive signals omnidirectionally, but transmits signals directionally. Because it incorporates certain algorithms, it can analyze the characteristics of the signal to calculate from which direction the signal is coming, and then use beamforming to direct the transmission of the signal. That is, omnidirectional reception and directional transmission. Smart antennas. Then, classified by polarization method, antennas can be divided into single polarized antennas and dual polarized antennas. This concept of polarization will be discussed in a later video. A basic understanding here will suffice. Like this omnidirectional antenna, it is a single polarized antenna, and it is vertically polarized, meaning its electric field is oriented vertically. So it is vertically polarized. Then, classified by shape, antennas can be divided into whip antennas, panel antennas, and plate antennas. Whip antennas are generally used indoors, like the antennas on our home Wi-Fi routers. These antennas are whip antennas and are detachable. Then, plate antennas are generally used outdoors, like panel antennas. For example, the antennas installed in our hallways are panel antennas. Panel antennas are these. Then, classified by location, we can divide them into external and internal antennas. Now, considering the need for aesthetics, we generally use internal antennas. From the outside, it's not apparent how many antennas are actually inside. Let's also understand the common WLAN antenna types. First is the indoor ceiling antenna, which must be lightweight, aesthetically pleasing, and easy to install. We often see some places have ceilings or frameworks above with their ceiling antennas. Then, they are connected to their signal sources via feeder lines. They are generally used in indoor distribution systems. Then, there's the indoor wall-mounted antenna, also known as the indoor directional antenna. Indoor wall-mounted antennas must also be lightweight and aesthetically pleasing, and offer the advantage of easy installation. This is its antenna, which is also connected to its signal source through a feeder line. Indoor wall-mounted antennas can achieve directional coverage, while indoor ceiling antennas can provide comprehensive coverage. However, by comparison, the gain of indoor wall-mounted antennas is a bit higher than that of ceiling antennas. We will discuss the concept of gain in the next video. Then there are outdoor antennas, which are used for WLAN outdoor coverage solutions. First is the outdoor omnidirectional antenna, which is a dual-band antenna, meaning it supports both 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz frequency bands. It has two characteristics. One is a wide coverage area, meaning it can provide 360-degree coverage, but it has a relatively low gain, meaning its coverage distance is relatively short. Then there are outdoor backhaul antennas, which are typically used in conjunction with outdoor omnidirectional antennas. It is a directional antenna. For instance, here we have an outdoor omnidirectional antenna, and around it, we place some outdoor backhaul antennas. The outdoor omnidirectional antenna provides full range coverage, while the outdoor backhaul antennas facilitate the backhauling of signals. The last one, the outdoor directional antenna, like the outdoor backhaul antennas, is also a directional antenna. It is also a dual band antenna, supporting both 2.4G and 5G frequencies. Both of these are directional antennas. Relative to outdoor omnidirectional antennas, their gain is a bit higher, meaning they can cover a further range in specific directions. Next, let's learn about smart antennas. A smart antenna is an array of antennas, meaning it consists of a group of antennas arranged together. This group of antennas is copolarized with low gain. These antennas are arranged together to perform directional enhancement of signals through algorithms. For example, here is a user. The signals generated between them will interfere algorithmically, producing a signal that is enhanced in the direction of the user. The two images below show its two different operating modes. In receiving mode, it operates in an omnidirectional mode to receive signals, meaning it can receive signals from 360 degrees. Then, in transmission mode, it operates in a directional radiation mode, applying algorithmic signal enhancement in the direction of the user. The right image is Huawei's smart antenna architecture. Huawei's smart antenna has four vibrators. We will discuss later what a vibrator is, and it has 16 antennas, four for 2.4G and 12 for 5G. Thus, it can realize combinations in 2 to the 48th different directions, essentially enabling directional enhancement in every direction. We'll just briefly understand this for now, and that concludes this part of the lesson. In this lesson, we covered the definition and functions of antennas, as well as some of their properties. We also discussed the classification and forms of antennas, and introduced smart antennas. In the next lesson, we will discuss technical points related to antennas, including the basic operating principles and classic performance parameters of antennas.